story started 20 years ago. Went to Lakshadweep as a tourist to see the place. It was the first time I put the mask on my face and looked underwater at the fish. I was sold, never looked back. The diving instructor, I ran that place for 10 years. Came back to Bombay, wanted to start my own, so I started Orca Dive Club. So the idea was to get scuba into the city. People had to travel for long spells, so I got the sport closer, so at your convenience you can complete most of the park certification course in Bombay, but the ultimate open water scenarios have to happen at a diving lesson. Try diving, you don't need to know swim. As soon as they say I want to get certified, then there are a few prerequisites. So swimming is a prerequisite where you should know how to swim. Not necessarily that you know how to swim like a champion swimmer, but at least you don't have the fear of water. You're water friendly. You can look after yourself alone in the water if you are. If you're thrown off a boat, you shouldn't be sinking. You should be able to swim back to the boat, or you should be able to swim back to shore. Try a dive in a pool where you can stand in waist-deep waters. Get the feel of the equipment, breathe underwater. Once we tell you to kneel down, the water level, which is at your chest level, will go above your head. So you are underwater, submerged, breathing with scuba equipment. Okay, so to go scuba diving, you need to first know what is the meaning of scuba. S-C-U-B-A, self-contained underwater breathing apparatus. Right? So these are the three little pieces of equipment that we need to first form the aqua lung so that you can breathe. So this is your little scuba tank, which is filled with compressed air and not oxygen. Then you have a BCD or a buoyancy control device that will hold your tank and allow you to maintain buoyancy in the water. Last but the most important is your regulator, which allows you to breathe in the water at ambient pressure. That's why it's called a regulator.